On location, take one.
Coming up next on Location, we'll be reviewing Whatever It Takes and Aaron Brockovich.
Plus, we'll have Joel Lockhart with a video rental review on Check It Out.
It's all on the way, so stick around. On Location, we're up next. Ah, yes. Welcome to our little show. We like to call it On Location. As always, we are your hosts, Dennis Brutton.
And I'm Jamie Sire.
All right, let's jump into our first clip. This is a clip from the movie Whatever It Takes.
What's he all dressed up for?
His mom died. Earlier today. Ladies, sit tight.
All right, that was a clip from Whatever It Takes, a movie about four young high schoolers in search for love. How sweet. Anyways, here's the deal. Ryan, he's the main character. He's the high school nerd. Now, he plays the accordion, gets good grades, all that, yada, yada, yada. And he just happens to be in love with the most popular girl at his high school, Ashley. Now, the only problem is Ashley will not give Ryan the time of day. That's okay, Ryan. We all know how you feel. Anyways, Ryan's best friend, Maggie, well, she's supposed to be a nerd, too, but she doesn't really look like one. Anyways, Chris, who's the popular high school football player, well, he's in love with Maggie, but she won't talk to him because she thinks he's too stupid. So anyways, the two guys come up with this brilliant idea where they're each going to help each other out by hooking each other up with good advice to how to get to the right girl. And that is basically the plot of the movie. It just goes on and on and on until it reaches the very, very predictable ending. So, Jamie, what do you think about Whatever It Takes?
Well, I totally agree with you on the predictable ending thing. Basically, I knew what was going to happen like 5 minutes into the movie. So, I won't ruin it for you, anybody who is planning on seeing it, but it pretty much gives it away out at the beginning, so.
Yeah, you know, I just don't understand. Maggie, she's supposed to be like this nerd, but she's totally hot. What's up with that? Hey, do you remember her? She was on Full House.
Yeah, I do remember that.
Ooh, what a cutie. Anyways, what are you going to give this for stars?
This is basically like any other high school movie that has ever been made. So if you take Can't Hardly Wait, She's All That, 10 Things I Hate About You, throw them together with some bad acting and you have Whatever It Takes. So I didn't really like it, but if you kind of like those kind of movies, then here's another one for you. But I'm going to give it 2 stars. Don't go see it.
Yeah, this movie was absolute cheese. It was pretty lame. And you know, I know the four Pullman High girls that were sitting in front of me just absolutely loved it, but I'm sorry, girls. I'm going to have to disagree with you. This movie was lame. I'm going to give it 1 star for the cute girls, and that's about that.
Okay, well, coming up after break, don't go away because Joel Lockhart will be here with a video rental review.
Stick around.
All right, well, that was a clip from Aaron Brockovich. As you saw from the clip, it's pretty much about Aaron, who is a young single mother who is always trying to provide, you know, the best for her children. So the movie starts out with Aaron Brockovich, who is played by Julia Roberts, and she gets into a car accident, and she ends up losing her lawsuit. So upon hearing the verdict, she's just totally furious, and she immediately blames her lawyer, Ed. She makes him feel so bad that she convinces him into giving her a job. And so the movie kind of takes off from there. She totally goes beyond all of her responsibilities as this legal assistant. And she ends up kind of uncovering like a little scandal concerning water contamination. So she ends up putting all of her time and energy into working on this project in an attempt to expose this multi-million dollar corporation. So that's pretty much the gist of the movie. So, Dennis, what did you think?
Ah, yes. Aaron Brockovich. First off, let me say, Julia Roberts, wow. The Wonder Bra really does miracles, doesn't it? But seriously, this was a good show. I really did like it. And I like the fact that it was a true story, too.
All right. Well, aside from Julia Roberts' breasts, her acting job was really, really good. She had a really believable character, and it was really well presented, and I think that she's definitely going to be up for or even win some awards next year at the award ceremony. So, excellent job.
Hey, you know another thing I liked about Erin Brockovich was the attitude that she had. Kind of a sassy little fireball that doesn't take lip from anybody. Loved it.
Yeah, I definitely think that aspect was what made the relationship between her and her boss so, I don't know, interesting to watch, because, like, you know, she was sassy and then he was kind of conservative, and so the chemistry and how they worked together, just, I don't know, it really worked well for each other, so I really like that.
Hey, like I said before, I really did like this movie, but at times it was a little boring and it did get long also. But either way, I'm going to give it 3 stars. I thought it was pretty good, and I think you should go see it. And it might win an Oscar, so keep your eyes peeled for Aaron Brockovich.
Okay, well, I definitely more than agree with Dennis. It was excellent. I absolutely loved this movie. It was one of those movies where you felt so great at the end that you just, like, wanted to start clapping or cheering or something. I don't know. I really liked it. I'm going to give it 4 stars just because that's the highest amount of stars I can give it. If I could give it more, I would. I think everybody definitely needs to see this movie. It's just awesome. You have to go see it.
Uh-oh. It looks like we're out of time. Thanks for watching On Location, everybody. And next week, tune in because we'll be reviewing High Fidelity and The Skulls.
All right, and if anybody would like to email us with some fan mail or comments or questions, be sure to check us out at onlocation8@hotmail.com.
We'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching.